I have to admit, I'm a little bit xenophobic. I'm nervous around some cultures, particularly those who proudly put up on display that they do not put intellect and compassion high up on a pedestal. Cultures that celebrate unrestrained instincts and reflexes. It's very primal. There's also a tribalistic element to it as well. I can't wrap my mind around cultures that laugh at terrible things physically happening to people. I remember that clip that was floating around for a while of some teens that were laughing hysterically at a man that was drowning. And when he went under the final time, they went, "Ha ha, he died." Then there was the knockout game that was a thing for a while, where groups of people would find unsuspecting, innocent people on the street, and they'd record themselves knocking them out with one punch. Ha ha. Just can't wrap my mind around that kind of mentality. Heck, back in 98, I was watching The Titanic with a friend of mine in a theater, and a big group of people sitting in the back were laughing hysterically at all the violent scenes. One of them yelling, "Ha ha, she flew!" Kind of ruined the movie for me and my friend. We both almost walked out of the theater. It was messed. Yeah, I just don't have any respect for cultures that act in such primal, uncompassionate ways. When I see people putting those kind of mannerisms and modes of interacting on display in a prideful way, I stay far away. And it's certainly not a race thing, because anyone of any race can be part of that kind of a culture. And there are many variations on that type of culture. It's a celebration of violence and tribalism. It's a complete lack of compassion. It's the denial of intellect. This is the only kind of thing that gets in the way of my fully embracing multiculturalism. And let me interject that I mostly embrace multiculturalism. I'm 90% there. I argue for multiculturalism most of the time. But I'm not 100% there. Okay? And I understand that the melting pot is a failed analogy. It's unsustainable. I accept that multiculturalism is the future, and that it's futile to try to stop it. But I also accept that with more diversity comes more chaos that we have to get used to. Diversity is inevitable. Multiculturalism is inevitable. But there are some cultures that I'm simply not going to embrace, regardless of how much I'm guilt-tripped. As long as they're not attacking me, and they're not attacking innocent people, I simply let them exist without complaint. But it's very unlikely that I'll be friends with them. They'd probably have some choice words to describe me anyway, since I'm gay. Anyway.